Welcome to the 1 minute apologist. We interview the world's leading apologists to provide credible answers to curious questions.
What are undesigned coincidences?
Undesigned coincidences is when you have two independent historical accounts and they interlock in such a way that would be unexpected if they were just making the story up. It's best explained by giving examples, so let me just give an example. Yeah. Take, for example, in Mark 14, verse 58, and Matthew 26, verse 61, when Jesus is before the high priest, Joseph Caiaphas, and the false witnesses step forward, and they say, "We heard this man say, I will destroy this man-made temple and rebuild it in 3 days, but not by human hands." Now, you'll notice nowhere in Matthew nor Mark or do we read a report of Jesus having actually said this or anything even approximating to this? And so it raises a question in the audience's mind, what does Jesus actually say? If you go over to John's Gospel, the independent non-synoptic account, we read in John chapter 2, verses 18 and 19, when the Pharisees say to Jesus, "What miraculous sign can you show us to prove your authority to do all these things?" And he says, "I will destroy the temple, this temple, and rebuild it in 3 days," of course referring to his body. And so John actually gives us the pretext, but not the later misrepresentations and its use as an accusation. The synoptics give us the later misrepresentations, but not the pretext. So you have this hand-in-glove fit, if you will. Just to give one more example, in John chapter 6, you have the feeding of the 5,000, and Jesus turns to Philip to say, "Where should we send these people to buy bread?" And it raises the question in the audience's mind, why would he turn to Philip? Because Philip's a pretty minor character in the Gospels. Why not turn to Judas, who was in charge of the money, or Matthew, the tax collector, or someone like that? Well, if you read in John chapter 1 and John chapter 12, we learn that Philip was from a certain town called Bethsaida. But we learn from Luke's account in Luke chapter 9 that the event of the feeding of the 5,000 takes place in Bethsaida. But Luke doesn't tell us he turned to Philip, it just says he turned to the disciples. So you have this hand-in-glove fit, this undesigned coincidence, if you will, which suggests that this narrative has a ring of truth. On its own, one example of this undesigned coincidence might not be compelling to convince you that the New Testament is generally reliable, but if you have a network of these undesigned coincidences, it forms a consilience of evidence, or a cumulative case, if you will, for the historical veracity of Scripture.